Hello students, in previous session I introduced a biomolecule polypeptide commonly known as protein. In this session, let us continue the second biomolecule commonly known as energy producer, that is carbohydrate. It is the product of photosynthesis. So naturally, producers in any ecosystem, that is plants, will generate primary product, that is carbohydrate. On this, many consumers are depending, and this is the source of transferring energy in the form of food. These carbohydrates are commonly known as sugars. Sugars fall in different groups, like monosaccharides. We call them as simple sugars. These are highly reducing sugars. They are highly soluble. They can easily diffuse across the membrane. These simple sugars are easily available to the cell to generating the energy by undergoing oxidation process. Thus, monosaccharides are specified with a general formula CnH2O(n). Depending upon the number of carbon atoms in a molecule, we classify monosaccharides or simple sugars into five groups like triose, tetrose, pentose, hexose and heptose. Like triose is C3H6O3, tetrose is C4H8O4, pentose is C5H10O5, hexose is C6H12O6, heptose is C7H14O7. Thus, when you see the ratio between hydrogen and oxygen, it is always maintained as 2:1. In monosaccharides, the most stable sugars are pentose and hexose. Pentose sugar, we call it as ribose, and it is a component of nucleic acids, DNA and RNA molecules. Hexose sugars are found in our staple food like cereals and millets. They are also found in the milk and they are also present in the fruit pulp. Based on that, we classify them as glucose, galactose and fructose. Coming to the second group, where monosaccharides are linked by a glycosidic bond eliminating and water molecule. Commonly available disaccharides are sucrose, maltose and lactose. Sucrose usually found in the plant cells. For example, sugarcane. Maltose is present in all cereals and millets. And lactose is found in the milk. So sucrose is formed by polymerizing. It is not exactly polymerization. Sucrose comprises glucose and fructose. Maltose comprises two glucose molecules and lactose is composed of glucose and galactose. Thus, more than two monosaccharides and less than 10 monosaccharides in a chain, we call them as oligosaccharides. They may be trisaccharides, tetrasaccharides, pentasaccharides, hexasaccharides, etc. And when the number of monosaccharides exceeds than 10 up to infinite, we call it as polysaccharides. So here, carbohydrates are available in four forms: monosaccharides, disaccharides, oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. Now these polysaccharides are divided in two groups: homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. Homopolysaccharides contain similar types of monosaccharides, while heteropolysaccharides are composed of different monosaccharides. Homopolysaccharides, which are abundantly found in our biokingdom, are cellulose, which forms the cellulose, which forms the cell wall, then starch, which is a stored food in almost all plant cells or autotrophs. Glycogen is generally called animal starch, means it is a stored food in animal cells, while heteropolysaccharides are also available in different forms. These carbohydrates, when you learn as mono, di, oligo and polysaccharide. Simple sugars are soluble in water. Hence, they can easily pass through semi-permeable membranes. They are sweet to taste. But polysaccharides, they become insoluble in water. They are unable to pass through semi-permeable membranes and they remain tasteless. Thus, second biomolecule is carbohydrate. So, this topic we have initiated with the biomolecule heading. Using trichloroacetic acid as a medium, we can separate macro and micromolecules. Macromolecules forms acid insoluble pool as a retentant and they are classified as proteins. These are bodybuilders. Carbohydrates, these are energy producers. Lipids are thermoregulators. Here lipids are coming under micromolecules. So in the next session, I'll continue with lipids followed by nucleic acids. With this, I'll conclude. Thank you very much.